Welcome, Saugerties Class of 2025. I'm Mr. Reid, and I'm the Senior High School Principal of Saugerties Schools. We're excited to have you join our senior high community next year, and we are fast preparing for this transition. Dr. Catalano, Senior High School Guidance Counselor, will give an overview of some of the requirements, pathways to graduation, and some of the other options you should consider as you enter Saugerties High School. Watch the presentation, and as questions arise, feel free to reach out to us. We look forward to providing you with the best possible school experience. We're looking forward to having you join our senior high school community. See you soon.
Oh, hello, everyone, parents and students. I am Dr. Catalano, one of the high school guidance counselors here at Saugerties High School, and I will be covering ninth grade orientation for you this evening. Let's just jump right into it. So who is your 9th through 12th grade counselor? So it's hard to believe we're already halfway through the school year of 2021. In another 6 months, you guys and girls are going to be turning into 9th graders. So it's important to know who is your counselor. Ms. Egan covers last names with A through FA, Ms. Madden, FE through LO, Ms. Greener, LU through M, and I cover students with last names that begin N through Z. Okay, so what is the role of the school counselor? To help students focus on academic, career, and social emotional development so they can achieve success in school and are prepared to lead fulfilling lives as responsible members of society. So how do we achieve this? Every single day of the school year, we are here to help students in anything that comes up. And also, you know, here's some examples. Student can't open their locker. They're having problems with a friend and don't know how to work through the issue. There's an elective class that they do not like and they want to get out of there and choose something different. They want to talk about college planning. They want to talk about internship experiences and capstone. We wear a lot of different hats here in the guidance office. And we do everything humanly possible to help each student every single day. And we are very approachable, very visible. And there's different means of ways of communicating with this COVID world we're living in. So if we are full remote, you know, we can do video conferencing, we can do telephone. If kids are coming into the school on a cohort A and B schedule, students can come in, talk with the school counseling secretaries, and our office is right next to the principal's office, and we'll see you and have a conversation, see what we can do to assist you, in working through whatever it is that you're dealing with or address your question. You may have just a general question. Just to let you guys and girls, parents all know that the school counselors work in tandem with building level principal, assistant principal, school nurse, teachers. We have an SRO resource officer, Officer Winchell. There are a lot of different people we interact with every single day, school psychologist, school social worker, et cetera. So there is a collective team. We're just a piece of that team. And I feel that we're a very, very important piece. So I'm hoping that parents and students utilize this as a tool to assist them and to make the high school experience an enjoyable experience. So that's what we do. So let's shift gears and go and talk about New York State high school graduation requirements for the class of 2021 and thereafter. So before I dive into diploma types, I want to just preface that New York State Education Department have a lot of rules and regulations as it relates to diploma types and gives us a lot of latitude to help every single student. And they realize that not every student is the same. You know, there's no one size fits all mentality. The state recognizes there needs to be different options. I'm going to talk about like 95% of the diploma types because it covers just about everyone. But in some cases, students will have to see their counselor one-on-one and they can go over everything as it relates to them. So there are some outliers or extreme circumstances, but I'm just going to hit the main ones for this presentation. All right, so let's talk about diploma types. Local diploma, Regents diploma, Regents diploma with advanced designation, Regents diploma with advanced designation with honors. Local and Regents diplomas. So you're going to hear me talk about units. Units basically are years of study. 4 units of English. 4 units of social studies. In social studies, the progression is Global 9, Global 10, U.S. History and Economics and Government in senior year. 3 units of mathematics. Integrated algebra is one of those math units that must be achieved by this diploma type. 3 units of science. We ask students to, of one of the 3 units, we encourage living environment as one of those. A unit of a second language, unless a student has a foreign exemption. In some cases, students have a foreign exemption, and we just basically take this out of the diploma type. 1 unit of art or music, or a half unit of design drawing for production, which is a technology class. Half unit of health, 2 units of phys ed. So half unit of health, half a year. 2 units of phys ed is a quarter credit per semester over the course of 4 years. 3.5 units of elective credits. So the minimum needed total is 22 credits for graduation. Students typically achieve about 6.5 credits per year. So, you know, you're looking at a little over 19 credits after junior year. So there's not a lot of credit that needs to be achieved as a senior in order to meet just the basic requirements of graduation. Of course, we encourage students to always fill their schedule and learn as much as possible because it gives better preparation to really transition into the real world, whether it's the military, right to work, two-year college, four-year college, etc. The more exposure to curriculum while in high school, I think it makes just a better, well-rounded person. Regents diploma with advanced designation. So the one that I just covered prior to this typically deals with a two-year college, people going right into an apprenticeship or the military or to work. This type of diploma is a typical four-year college-bound student. 4 units of English, 4 units of social studies, 3 units of mathematics. 3 units of mathematics for this type of student typically is going to be integrated algebra, geometry, and algebra 2 and trigonometry. Those 3 classes must be taken and passed or a student cannot receive an advanced designation. The math seems to be the big determiner on whether someone's going to get this diploma type or not, because some of our students do struggle in mathematics. So let's move on. 3 units of science, 3 units of a second language, or 1 unit of a second language, and 5 units of art, music, business, or BOCES. The New York State Education Department recognizes that some students are not foreign language proficient at the year 2 and 3 level and would rather choose a different pathway. So the state does recognize different pathways for kids. So they say, all right, if a student does just the 1 year, which is mandated, they can take 5 credits of art, music, business, or BOCES. So let's say, for example, some student says, you know, I'm really interested in pursuing cosmetology or electrical construction and maintenance, or welding, or some area in the BOCES. If they get 5 credits there and they get 1 credit in a foreign language, they're basically very good to go. They can move forward with this diploma type. A unit of art or music, or 1 unit of design drawing for production, which is a tech class, 0.5 unit of health, 2 units of phys ed, 1.5 units of electives, and 22 minimum credits. So there's a lot of common threads between the diploma types, between the local regents and the advanced. The big thing is the level of classes that kids have to take are higher, especially in the science and the science and the math areas. So let's move on. New York testing requirements for a local diploma. This is only for special ed students. And keep in mind, for you students who are special education can get a Regents diploma. They can get an advanced diploma. They can get one with honors. There is nothing blocking a special education student from getting a higher diploma type than the one I'm about to cover here. So this is just simply saying for special ed students who are struggling, the New York State Education Department says, we will allow you still to graduate if you meet this benchmark, okay? Comprehensive English, 55 to 64. Comprehensive English, 11th grade, January is typically when we offer the examination. If for some reason an exam is not passed, students can always retake it. We offer it typically three times a year. We offer it in January, June, as well as the summertime. Now, of course, lately, the New York State Education Department, due to COVID issues, have basically waived the Regents exam. So in that situation, if it's waived, we just log it in that the child was exempt from the exam, and we check the box that they've met the requirement. That is subject to change, though. U.S. History and Government Regents, 55 to 64. U.S. History Regents exam is after 11th grade social studies class in June. Global History and Geography after 10th grade is achieved, and that would be Global 9 and 10 material. Integrated Algebra, 55 to 64. Typically, integrated algebra is achieved for the majority of kids, I would say ninth grade, but our accelerated kids have that completed in eighth grade. Science Regents exam, 55 to 64. Okay, so here's the Regents. So with the Regents examination, the difference between local and Regents is the state of New York Education Department is looking for a 65 or greater. So you can see Comprehensive English, U.S. History, Global, Integrated Algebra, and a Science Regents examination. So all 65s or higher. Okay, New York testing requirements for Regents diploma with advanced designation. So the diploma types that I just covered prior to this typically deal with a two-year college-bound student, someone who's interested in the military, or someone's planning to go right to work, or an intern, or they want to take an apprenticeship. This diploma type that I'm covering right this second is dealing with the four-year college-bound student, most likely the student's going to go towards a four-year college degree. But in some cases, we have students with this diploma type who choose a two-year college because they want to save money. So, I would just frame it that it puts a student in a position, if they wanted to go right to a four-year college, they could. Now, some of these students go into the military still, and some of them go into internships, apprenticeships. But the majority that I've dealt with in the couple of decades I've been in the field of education, these students are going to a four-year college. So Comprehensive English 65 or higher, U.S. History 65 or higher, Global 65 or higher. And here's where the big difference is. In the mathematics area, students have to pass a Regents exam with a 65 or higher in algebra, geometry, and algebra 2 and trig. There is no wiggle room. The state of New York, their firm, they've got to do the integrated algebra, geometry, and algebra 2 and trig. They must get a 65 or higher. Science, they call for two science Regents exams. As you remember in the slide prior to this, it only called for one Regents in science, but for the advanced, student needs at least two, one in life and one in physical. Now, students who complete 3 years of a foreign language, there'll be a test at the end of level 3. And we want kids to get through that. But I want to preface this. This is very, very, very important for parents and students to really, really be aware of. I'm going to give you an example of something I dealt with. I had a student not long ago it was last year, who was looking at a SUNY school, a four-year SUNY school. And the person in charge of that department that the student was thinking of entering said, you need 4 years of foreign language in order to be accepted into our program. So it's smart. It's really smart to try to work backwards. Once a student has a sense of where they want to go, is to work backwards and see what does that particular college, what do they want? And kind of map out the course selections according to where they want to go. So it's very normal for the majority of students to have absolutely no idea where they want to go. And many times kids change their mind, which is extremely normal. I would say the majority of kids, even when they graduate, are still very confused. Our goal is to give them such a good background that they can be successful in any program they choose. So it should always be something every single year that kids are reflecting and thinking about, what do I want to do? You know, what's a checklist of items that I'm looking for in a particular college? You know, things like, does it have to be in New York State, or am I opening it up to, you know, different states in the country? Is cost an issue? Is distance an issue from home? Class sizes? You know, some students are interested in doing a lot of research, so they want like a research type university, and not all of them are research, like heavily research oriented, and so forth. Parents are concerned about their safety of their child once they do go to college. Like, you know, is my kid going to be safe in the environment? I've had some students, you know, talk to me even about food plan and internship experience and so forth. So it's important to start having this thought process as you navigate through 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. And we definitely have some different career activities, and we have a different software available to help students kind of sort some of these feelings out. So let's move on. All right, so this is basically our top diploma type. And I would say that less than 1% of our student population achieve this diploma type. It's called a Regents Diploma with Advanced Designation. And I commend students who can achieve this level. This is like off the charts level. And are the colleges that are the hardest to get into are going to be looking at this type of diploma. But I want to extend this, and I commend any student for any diploma type, as long as a student is working up to their maximum potential, whether it's a local diploma, a Regents diploma, a Regents with Advanced Designation, or this diploma. I've had some students, believe it or not, who've achieved this diploma and didn't really work as hard as they could. It just, everything came kind of natural to him or her. And I've had special ed students who work extremely hard to the highest level to achieve a local diploma. So the main thing is to work to the max abilities. But the most elite or challenging colleges to get into, they are looking for this type of diploma type. These type of students are, you know, getting usually, you know, mid 90s to upper 90s all during their high school experience. So here's an example of a 4 year college plan. English 9R plus, 10R plus, 11R plus, English in the arts, global studies 9, 10, 11, economics and government, algebra, applied geometry, real world math, etc. So this is an example of a 4 year plan for a local and Regents diploma student. You can see 22 credits. Now let's just look at each year what they're achieving. So they got 6.5, 7, and 6.5. In the first 3 years, this student has what? 6, 6, and 6, 18, 19.5, 19.5 credits. So it could easily, or actually 18, 19, 20, no, 20 credits. 20 credits already. So in senior year, the only thing that would have had to have been achieved is English 12, social studies 12, and physical education. And the student has all the credits that they need to graduate high school. So it's easily achieved if a student just does the basic things that they need to. Attend every day, try their best, do all their homework. So let's look at one with an advanced designation type track. You can see just by looking at here, these courses are more difficult, they're more challenging, okay? That usually separates the local regions to the Regents Diploma with Advanced Designation. So let me bring us back to our original slide. And I just want to say I appreciate you watching this presentation. I'm not going to give you a quiz on everything. There's a lot of information that I just presented. We are here to help. I just want to reiterate to parents and students, we are here to help anytime you need us. And no question is a stupid question. I'd rather have a parent call me, you know, 50 times to deal with certain things, and let's settle things in a healthy way to help your child grow to the best of their ability. We really like the communication. And like I said in the presentation, a lot of this, you know, for students to do well is simply, you know, attend school regularly, try your best, do your homework. And we do have resources available to help students who are struggling. So it could be peer-to-peer tutoring. It could be staying after with a teacher. It could be even doing video conferencing with a teacher. We have a lot of resources. And when students come back permanently into the building, we even have other types of services to help the student find success. So again, let me mention our telephone number here in the school counseling office is 845-247-6651. The extension is 1800. And to all you eighth graders out there, I wish you, and I know I speak for all the guidance counselors here, the best for the second half of the year. For some of you, you are struggling. Don't quit. Work hard. Check in with the teachers if you're feeling like you're overwhelmed. Get a starting point of where you're at, because some of you, I'm sure, are a little confused on where you are in the class. And then the teacher will guide you on what you need to do next to basically get into the gear you need to find success and pass that class. And for those students who have been doing their work every single day, working extremely hard, you know, we commend you on that. It's not easy to do that consistently. So keep up the good work, and you all take care. Bye-bye.